see you there again. Welcome back to my kitchen. Now, last time in my kitchen, we were curdling milk, which was gross. So this time, I thought I'd do something tasty. So we're going to do some cooking, and hopefully some of you can watch this at home on YouTube later on, maybe at the weekend, and do some cooking with Mum and Dad, and maybe say thank you for all the amazing things they're doing for you at home at the moment, because Mums and Dads are great. Grands and grands like this too, so cook for anyone you like, I don't care. So we're going to do some cooking, so come over. We are going to make today Mr. Newport's special potato gratin, spinachy, kale-y, cheesy, bacony, slicey thing. I don't know what it's called, it's probably got a really posh name. I discovered it during lockdown when me and Mrs. Newport were completely out of food, and short of just sticking the spoon straight in the Marmite, we had to think outside the box. And this is all we had left in the house. So we chucked it all in a pan and it tasted great. So what we're going to do is I'm going to talk you through each step. So if you're watching this at home, you can pause it. And if you're just watching it for an assembly, then just sit back and enjoy and think of the cool stuff you can do in your kitchen. Okay, so first thing we need is we need potatoes. So, first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to magic up some potatoes. So, potatoes! Bing! Nice. You want about as many potatoes as fit in the pan that you're going to cook in. So, whichever pan you've got, fill it with potatoes. That is how many potatoes you need. So, there's my potatoes. The next thing I'm going to need to do is I'm going to need to peel all of them. So, I'm going to speed this up, otherwise you're going to have to watch for about 20 minutes, which is going to be totally lame. So I'm going to go and I'm going to hit my chopping board. Super, super exciting. Chopping board. Love a chopping board. And I need a peeler. There's my peeler at. I need my peeler. Peter the peeler and Chip the chopping board. That's their names. I name everything. Right, so I'm just going to peel all my spuds.
They're red, they're white, they're brown. They get that way underground. There can't be much to do. So now they have blue ones too. We don't care what they look like, we'll eat them. Any way they can fit on our plate. Every way we can conjure to heat them. We're delighted and think they're just great.
And we're done. Great. Okay, so I've peeled my potatoes. I'm going to put my peelings in the bin. And then we're going to come back and we're going to chop our potatoes up. So, super exciting. In they go. Excellent. Right, so I need Kennet the knife and I'm going to peel one of my potatoes. Now, obviously, because we're using peelers and knives, you need to make sure that anything you're doing in the kitchen, you've always got an adult with you, and never hold a knife like this, pointing it at Mrs. Newport, threateningly like this. So we're going to cut our potatoes. Now I'm gonna hold my potato really still, and you want the thinnest slices possible. So imagine you're making crisps, and you just want it cut it really thin, so as thinly as possible. So I'm just gonna cut it very, very thinly. Okay, so I've chopped up a potato, and now I'm going to chop up all the other ones using the power of video editing magic. So, bam! Yay! Okay, lots of sliced potatoes. Great, that's the first thing we need. Right, now what we need to do is we need to grate some cheese. So I've got this vast block of cheese here, so I'm going to take this out. Now, if you want to do a really posh one, you can use posh cheese. So if you'd like to use some Gouda or something, that'd be amazing, but you don't have to. So I'm just using sort of cheddar cheese. I'm gonna get my grater. Here's my grater. Graham the grater? Graham the grater. And he is gonna grate all the cheese. So more speed editing, here we go.
Yes, it's cheese, yes, it's cheese, yes, it's cheese. Cheese! Everyone loves cheese, yes they do. Gandhi eat cheese, Jesus eat cheese, everyone eat cheese, what else will they do? That's right. Cheese! Cheese is good, cheese is yellow.
And I'm done. Right, great. So me and Graham the Grater here have a fractious relationship. I've lost a knuckle to Graham the Grater before because I was going a bit too ham on the cheese and I was going far too quickly and it wasn't safe. So my grater tip for you is just to go nice and slowly and nice and steady, and that way you're not going to hurt yourself, because graters, especially ones like this, can really cut your fingers really badly. So you know, super important that you have good grater etiquette. Okay, now what we need to do is we need to cut our bacon. So I'm going to move my cheese board over here. And I'm going to bring back this board. If you're ever cutting meat, it's always good to have a fresh board, a different board that's only going to have meat on, or at least not have anything else after the meat. So there we go. Right, I've got my bacon. Cut into my bacon pack. Okay. Excellent. Now, you don't have to use bacon. If you just want it to be vegetarian, obviously just don't have bacon at all. It really is going to be lovely even without. Or you can use ham or gammon or even sort of Italian ham, sort of some pancetta or something. Anything like that would be absolutely great. But ham or bacon is perfect. So I'm going to put this... recycle. Lovely. Right, now I actually like to use scissors sometimes when I'm cutting bacon. That is an excellent way of cutting bacon, but I've just touched it. I need to wash my hands. Okay, I'm back. Right, let me get my food scissors out. Okay, so we're just going to cut all of the bacon into nice tiny little bits.
Rub some bacon on it.
Bacon's done and chopped. I'm going to put these straight into my dishwasher. There we go. Fantastic. Don't need them for anything else. Okay, so I've got my potato, I've got my bacon, and before I touch anything else, I obviously need to do another hand wash, and then we're going to put it all together and stick it in the oven. This is the exciting part. Right, so now what we're going to do is we're going to get a little bowl, because I've got one more ingredient that we need, and we're going to have to put that in the microwave because at the moment it's frozen. So I'm just going to get a bowl out. There we go. This over here. So what I've got here is I've got some spinach and some kale. Now, kale is fantastic and spinach is fantastic, and they're both kind of superfoods. And they're really good for you. And if you're not too great on eating your greens and your veg at home, then these are really good in this meal because they just kind of like melt in there and you can't really tell, but they're really super cool. And obviously Mrs. Newport is having a baby, so I will make sure I'm giving her all the superfoods, get all those vitamins and minerals in there. I want this baby to be an astronaut or something, so it's gonna need its kale. So I'm just gonna put quite a lot of kale and spinach in here. Some more. Okay, here we go. Put this back in my freezer. Fantastic. Brilliant. Okay, I'm gonna put a little lid on this. This is gonna go in the microwave probably for about 4 minutes just to really melt through. So, I'm going to take this out. Brilliant. Wonderful. Okay, so that's just melted nicely. Now, what I need to do is I need to strain off some of the liquid. So, I've got my little sieve. I'm going to take my bowl and I'm going to put it in there. Go. Awesome. Right. Just going to stand here for a little bit and just let it drain. So I'll come back to you in a sec. Right, welcome back. I've drained my kale and spinach nice and easy. Now I need to melt some butter. So I'm going to take my butter. You can use any sort of butter, it really doesn't matter. For this much potato, I'm going to need probably like a big sort of tennis ball sized bit of butter. Don't really do measurements. There we go. Take another little bit there. Brilliant. And I'm going to buzz this in the microwave quickly just to melt it. Probably only about 20 seconds. Okay, we're back. Right, I've got my melted butter. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to pour it onto my potatoes. Now, that's going to sort of harden up again pretty quickly because it's going to hit the cold potatoes. So you need to give it a pretty good stir pretty quickly. So just turn those potatoes over so that the butter really coats them all. Doesn't have to be perfect. There we go. Lovely. Okay. Right, I need to wash my hands again because they're a little greasy. When I come back, we're going to do some salt and pepper. Okay, I'm back. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to give a really good mill of black pepper. Again, this is completely optional. You don't have to. It'll taste great without it. But I like a good bit of pepper on there. So I'm just going to take my potatoes to pepper town for about 20 seconds. Lovely. Same thing with salt. Obviously, you never use too much. So I'm going to do much less salt than I did pepper. There we go. Fantastic. Give that a little bit of a stir. Like that. Fabulous. Okay. So if you look in there now, it's this nice potatoy, buttery, peppery goodness. It's absolutely fantastic. Now, I like to put a little bit of mustard in at this point, but you don't need to, and you might think, ah, mustard, gross. So I'm not going over this one, but like adults, a little teaspoon of mustard in there, really nice. Okay, so now we need to build our meal. So I've got everything I need. I've got my buttery, potato-y goodness. I've got my chopped up bacon. I've got my pan I'm going to use. I've got my kale and spinach. And I've got my cheese. Very, very important. Right, so now it's all about layering. So I'm going to do a layer, and I'm going to speed it up, and then you can see what's going on. So I'm going to take my bowl here, and you just start putting on little slices of potato all around the edge, like this. Doesn't matter what size is, doesn't even really need to be super neat. Don't worry too much if it's it's not a work of art, it doesn't matter. You're never going to see it. What you don't want though is just big clumps of potato. So just try and spread them out as much as you can. There we go. Don't worry if occasionally a slice is a bit thicker than the other ones. Again, it really doesn't matter. Okay, so I've got my layer of potato. Now I need to sprinkle on some of my other ingredients. You don't have to do all of them. It's a bit random. So I'm going to do a little bit of bacon. Now obviously I'm touching my bacon, but this is all going in the oven in a minute. And I'm obviously going to wash my hands straight afterwards. So I'm going to go from my bacon to my potato. That's okay. You don't need to wash your hands 20 times. As long as obviously you don't put your hands in your face or do anything else with your hands or eat with your hands. This is all going in the oven pretty soon. So I'm just going to put some bacon all over my potato. You don't have to do loads, just a little bit. There we go. I'm going to take some of my kale. I'm going to put that around too. There we go. Lovely. Brilliant. And then a little sprinkling of cheese. Beautiful. Fantastic. And then I'm going back to my potato for another layer. And you just keep repeating this until you run out of ingredients. So I'm going to speed this up. Shouldn't take too long. Cream and our milk on, but I'm going to need clean hands for that, so I'm just going to do a quick tidy. Okay everyone, I've tidied up a little bit, I've cleaned my hands, I've got some cream cheese here. Now you don't, again, this is pretty optional, but it does just make it nice and creamy when you're doing it. So you just want a little bit of cream cheese on there, not much, just a few little globules around the top. There we go. Ah! Oh, it's a cream cheese nightmare. Ah! Oh, the humanity. Okay, well, I'm ridiculously messy after what seemed to be a very simple cream cheese experiment. I'm going to wash my hands for about the eighth time. Alright, I'm going to give it one last go over with the pepper. There we go. And then this is the key ingredient. We need some double cream. Single cream does work, but it's definitely not as tasty. So I'm going to go with double cream. This is 300 millilitres in here, or just under. And I'm going to pour it all over. Try and get a good coverage. As far and wide as possible. Lovely. Okay. Then what you want is about the same amount of milk. So I'm actually just going to use the cream pot and I'm going to fill it up with milk. Okay. I'm just going to pour that on as well. Don't worry if the cream runs off, that's absolutely fine. Now, I'm actually just going to add a tiny bit more because this is quite a big dish. So, I'm just going to... There we go. That was about another half container. Okay, so I'm going to turn my oven on now. Now, I'm going to leave mine in the oven all night because I like it to be really, like, creamy and soft. But if you are trying to cook it just on the day for a dinner, then I reckon it needs about a minimum of an hour and a half. But if you can leave it for 2 or even 3 hours, even better. I'm going to put my oven on, so really cold. I'm going to put it on about sort of 120, 130. But if you're cooking it in an evening, then you'll probably want it on about 180. But you must cover your dish, otherwise it will burn. So I've covered my dish there. And I'm going to put my oven on just to about 120. There we go. Be very careful because it's full of fluid. Okay, right. I'm going to go to bed now. And then in the morning, we're going to come down and we're going to get it out and we're going to see what it looks like. And I think it's going to be absolutely brilliant. Okay, I'll see you all tomorrow. You can come in if you walk past the ICT suite at lunchtime. Me and Mrs. Newport are going to be eating this for our lunch. So give us a wave and we'll show you what it looks like. Hopefully, some of you give this a go as well, maybe over the weekend or in the summer holidays. If you do, maybe email the school a little picture of what you've done. And I'll put it up on Facebook or add it to the website on the assemblies page or something. That would be absolutely fantastic. So maybe give it a go. And if you really don't like kale or spinach, and this is what gets you into kale and spinach, then bonus points for you as well. You know, food of kings. Right. See you all later. I hope you had a good assembly and enjoy the rest of your day. Bye, everyone. Loving it. Good morning. Right, so I left the potato in for about 4 hours last night. Came down at about 2 o'clock to turn it off. 10 minutes ago, I just turned it back on, but removed the lid because I just want the top to brown nicely. So I'm going to take it out. Hopefully, it's going to be awesome. So it's all gone nice and golden yellow. Don't worry if the edges go a bit black, that's just because of the cream. So I'm going to get a spatula and I'm going to serve up Mrs. Newport's lunch. Okay, so it should just cut really nicely. Oh, so good. It smells amazing. All that cheesy, spinachy goodness. There we go. Right, that's Mrs. Newport's lunch. This should serve at least sort of 4 or 5 people. Maybe only 2 Mr. Newports, because I have mountains of food, but it should definitely feed a family, or at least a dish this size should feed a family. But you can make it any size you like, so little ones, big ones, it's all the same. But the longer it can cook, the better it can cook. And this one is marinated nicely. Good job, everyone. I hope you enjoyed that one. Weird little bit of cookery for you. I can't wait to see if any of you try it and send me a photo. That would be absolutely amazing. But enjoy the rest of your day, and I will see you for the next assembly next Tuesday. I've got a surprise for that one.